Here's the yarn.
With my hand.
This is what it's about.
How do I say, bitch, don't make me cry?
Hey, you guys.
Pain, don't write anything. Wait for a parent when you talk.
Your white friend.
Welcome back to another video. My name is Alethea. I'm at Michael's right now. I'm preparing for my first pop-up of the year. Janae is having her second birthday for her business, Shea Love Shea Butter. So she invited me to come celebrate with her and be a vendor. So I'm super excited, but I'm also nervous because as the days get closer, I'm realizing that I'm gonna need to be social. And if you know me, I'm usually by myself a lot of the time because I really just love alone time. So running a business, I feel like it's the polar opposite of me when it comes to interacting with people. So I'm really trying to get better at that this year. I know that I want to communicate with the people that are watching me, with the people that are purchasing from me, with the people that are doing similar things as me. I want to do that, but sometimes my anxiety can get in the way and I really love my alone time. So I'm trying to step outside of that and yeah, I'm excited. But it's just those jitters are starting to come in. I got a knitting machine. I came into Michael's to get it, something like a Centro, but it was $80 and they didn't have it in store that one day. It said it was in stock online, but when I actually came to the store, there wasn't any in stock. So I just went on Amazon and got a different one for $30 or $40, and it works. I made up a couple of hats on there. I made pants. If you wanna see those, they're on my Instagram and my TikTok, and I actually made it a short on here. So yeah, if you guys like watching shorts, then it should be in my shorts. I have about 10 hats started for the pop-up, and I just want to knit some designs into them or stitch some designs. Y'all know that I've been making hats for ever since I started crocheting and working with yarn. A while back, someone asked me if I could make a skirt or any type of clothing, and I have always wanted to, but now it just feels like it's actually in season. It's my time to break out of just making hats, so I'm really excited to do that. So I made pants and they look really cute. So yeah, without further ado, let's go get some chunky yarn because I want to make little bags.
And I'm thinking
because I know how I get when I go into a craft store looking for yarn specifically. I can be looking for one yarn and I come out with five. So I'm gonna give myself a limit of two chunky yarns for a bag, for two bags. I've never done it. I've watched a couple tutorials. I was watching one last night. I can use the chunky yarn for something else if it doesn't work out, but regardless, I have a limit of two yarns.
Okay, two.
I'm not telling y'all, I'm telling me. All right, let's go.
That is so lovely. Oh my goodness. And this one. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, it's between these. Those aren't super, super, super big.
So if I can find some that are a little bit chunkier, I'll get those. I know who probably has chunkier yarn. I don't have a gift card to them though. And they don't got 20% off today. I'm gonna just get one and get this color. Here's the yarn. That other yarn in there looked so good to me. reminded me of strawberry shortcake. Another thing, Michael's, if y'all shop at Michael's, let me know. Because one thing I noticed they're not doing anymore is adding on the little 20% discount little second sheet that it prints out on your receipts. What's that all about? Michael's. What's that all about, Michael's? Okay, so right now it's 5:54 p.m. These are hats that I've closed off already. They're all beanies. Now imagine this design. This is the base. Do we want to do this orange? It looks different on camera. Okay, I have this yarn. And then I have this yarn, which is still orange. It's just, can y'all hear it? It's a different material. What if, stay with me, I did this, did the heart outline and insides with this, right? And I outlined it with this. Woo! Tiana is having an event. I think the new brand name, business name is Be More Girly. It's a pop-up shop. And I think like in the future and from here on out, it'll be like events to bring the girls together. So hopefully I applied to be a vendor like a couple hours ago. And I was looking in the link tree for Be More Girly on Instagram. And there's a playlist for the event. So I'm going to listen to it. Love a good shuffle. I used to hate shuffling. I didn't like the mystery. Even though I'm the one who added all the music, I didn't like that. But now, I love shuffling. So I'm going to shuffle.
You know, a lot of girls.
This is my shit.
This one's for you.
I will not spend you.
Let me just have an honest, like, transparency moment with y'all. This is how it turned out. The heart is cute. What the hell is going on with these two? I feel like overall, you know, stitching into something that's already knit is very cute. But to do this for every single one of the hats that I've already made, I feel like it's not worth it. So I'm moving on. Let me show you what I plan to do. T-minus. It's Monday. Pop-up is Friday. So, in the previous clip, I was working on my first bag. And I want to show you guys what it looks like. Janae made another main post. She made another little updated post of who's gonna be there and all that stuff like that. And I haven't reacted or like interacted with the post at all yet, because I've been trying to get like most of my stuff together. I want to make an official post by like at the very least Wednesday, because I only have two more days to, you know, promo for this event. So yeah, I wanted to make an official post on my page and have like some of the items that I'm gonna be having with me, and yeah, to sort of, you know, build some more momentum and everything. So Let's do that. And one of these days, I'm gonna need to go to storage because I have a lot of my, like half of my pop-up stuff in storage, like the table and some other stuff. I forget what else, but I know I got other stuff in there. Just need to at least put something up on my story, you know, get the girls a little excited. And y'all, I was telling you, once I know how this bag comes out, once I find out that I can make a bag with my hands, it's over and done with. We're going back to Michael's and we're getting some more yarn. So that's the plan. I might get another one of my little panels just to post it on my story. Also, you guys. So the Be More Girly event that I was telling y'all about, I was accepted as a vendor. So I'm gonna just take a little cute little picture. I'm gonna zoom it in for my story post so you only see like this. I am so damn excited. I feel like this event is even more like my style because I feel like, even though I haven't seen the other vendors that are gonna be there, just based off of the things that I see the owner like post and like the way that she captures content and all that stuff and the way that she markets to her audience, like I'm really excited to see the type of people that this event brings together. I'm so excited.
I'm gonna be there.
I made it with my hands.
You should feel that.
In a smaller bag too, right?
Just like slightly shorter.
Yes. Yeah. I want to do like a bunch of sort of mini ones. Like the telly size.
Yo.
But yeah, I just made this.
Inventory up.
That's what I'm saying. Libby, I got accepted to be another vendor. February 18th.
We talking cloth about the banner. How much does the banner cost? The sign. How much does it cost?
What would the banner have on it?
You know what? How much does that cost? Tell me the cost.
Let me see.
I don't know.
Hey, you guys. It's another day. Another victory for the OG.
Another day, another victory for the OG. Taking down the sweats, the imposters among us.
Today is Thursday. Janae's event is now tomorrow. I need printer ink. After that, I'm going to Michael's and I'm gonna get one more chunky yarn. Now, last night I made two more chunky yarn bags and they're so cute, y'all. They're so cute. And I thought I was gonna make smaller ones, but honestly, I guess I counted too many stitches and it came out bigger than I thought it was gonna be. But it was still around the size of the first one that I made. So for the third one that I made, I just went ahead with it because it's okay. I do like the size. I just want to eventually make a smaller one. So I was a little nervous about filming this. Not nervous, but like I already knew that I had film that y'all haven't seen. So like starting something big again without already starting to edit what I have was a little bit intimidating. But I definitely was filming like a holiday vlog for y'all back in December. And I still have footage from that, from when I did my giveaway, from making holiday orders, crochet, ghettohippieco.com. Like, I have a bunch of that content. So I'm gonna go ahead and insert that now, and then I'll catch up with y'all later.
If you want to break up with me so you can see other women, just do it. Don't tell me you met another woman. Just end it if that's what you want.
I can't.
Sure you can. Here's how it goes. Meredith, I don't want to see you anymore. Meredith, I don't love you anymore.
Meredith. I do love you. Don't you see? I understand. You're the love of my life. I can't leave you. But you're constantly leaving me. You walk away when you want, you come back when you want. Not everyone. Not your friends. But you leave me. So I'm asking you. You don't see a future for us if you're not in this. Please. Please just end it because I can't. I'm in it. Put me out of my misery.
Christina is getting married. I have to go make sure she gets married.
Yeah.
I really need to make sure she gets down that aisle.
Let's go.
What's that Chance the Rapper song?
The one who fell off.
It's the one where it's like, don't let me show me over.
Yes. And I was listening to her music yesterday. I was like, I want to tell Kayla about the song, but she probably already know.
You know, like some of the old songs.
Beetlejuice, I love Beetlejuice. Yeah, yeah, that was my shit.
Oh, you flexing.
You know this song?
Hell yeah.
Do you know the live version?
Yeah, you put me on it.
Girl,
that is
put
actually,
that live on.
That is actually the best. They say he, I'll sing her every time.
Yeah, sure do. Yeah. Livy and I used to share the parts. I would be Alicia, she would be the guy. Okay.
Kick a rock.
Have fun, be happy. Christina, what are you doing here?
I can't go.
Yes, you can.
We have to finish.
You're gonna miss your...
We have to dance it out. That's how we finish. What are you doing? What, you're gonna call someone to make me leave or what?
finding a song. Okay, ready?
Wait. We'll call each other at least twice a month, and we'll text all the time.
Wait, text.
Text me, and don't let Owen get all dark and twisty. Take care of him. And Alex, take care of Alex. He needs to be mocked at least once a day, or he'll be insufferable. Don't get on any little tiny planes that can crash, or stick your hand in a body cavity that has a bomb in it, or offer your life to a gunman. Don't do that. Don't be a hero. You're my person. I need you alive. You make me brave. Okay. Now we dance it out.
Where do you go with your broken heart and soul? What do you do with the leftover you? And how do you know when to let go?
You love this song.
Where does the good go? Where does the good go? Look me in the eye and tell me you don't find me attractive. Look me in the heart and tell me you won't go. Look me in the eye and promise no love's like I love. Look me in the heart and unbreak broken.
Gifted surgeon with an extraordinary mind. Don't let what he wants eclipse what you need. He's very dreamy, but he is not the sun. You are.
You have to survive this too.
I know, but
hey, what do we always say?
We're both alive, that's what matters. Everything else is just bumps and bruises.
You can cry, Amber. It's fine. It's a lot to take in all at once.
No, she needs to stay positive. That's how we get through. We stay positive.
She was excited. She was hopeful. She was eager. And that has been crushed. She has the right to have some feelings. She can be positive tomorrow. You can be positive tomorrow.
Do you think your mom ever got over the chief?
Okay, so it's a lot more calmness than my phone was trying to tell me earlier. Like an hour ago, it said 9 comments, and I was trying to get it to refresh because I was like, ain't no way it's only 9 people that did this. For the amount of notifications I've gotten, y'all, 20 people commented. Yeah, some people have only done some of the steps, like commenting, either tagging one person or and not like reposting to their story, or yeah, that's pretty much all I see so far. I've only seen one person who didn't follow the giveaway rules. Yo, I'm already so excited to do another giveaway. I've been wanting to do a giveaway since before I had things to give away. Like, for my YouTube, I've always wanted to do a giveaway, but like give away a gift card or something. So yeah, this is so cool. Look at how many people enter my giveaway. Y'all will probably see this, so I'm gonna just go ahead and show you. This video will probably come out before then, but I took a picture of me. This was like my first day of school, back at school at Morgan, first day of college.
I clocked out at school, came home, clocked into Ghetto Hippie Co., packed up the rainbow hat order that I made, and then had my mom take this picture. And we took a couple too, because I wanted to try out my different films. And then I also had two other orders going out that day. It's showing it kind of weird with the camera quality, but. I'm gonna send this to my sister. It is 11:51. I said that I would announce the winner at 12 p.m. for my giveaway. And I was able to change like the color and everything, thank goodness. But this is everybody that entered. Thank you everybody who entered. Oh my goodness. I am shocked. I'm shocked. I didn't think this many people would enter. And it makes me want to pick like two winners at least, but I really only have enough yarn for one. And this yarn is a little bit harder to get because it's not like pride season, and it was easier to get around that time. So maybe next time, but I'm about to hit enter. Okay, let's go. Ah, I'm scared. Okay, how do I do it? Okay, I need to take her name. I'm gonna fucking throw up. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, screenshot. Because so many people entered, like, I feel bad. I'm happy for Lindsay, but like, you know, like, I didn't know this many people would be interested in this damn hat. Guys, my first giveaway. Oh my gosh. Okay, next time I'm definitely doing more than one winner. Or should I just... I didn't make a template that would hold two winners. I could though, hold on. I just don't know how available it's gonna be, y'all. Oh my god, she won, bro. That, yo, wow. Wow. Oh my god! Me for the next, like, couple of days. Screaming at the fact that I did this giveaway and Lindsay won. Also, Lindsay bought a hat from me this summer. Is that good? Period. And damn, I need to call Tay. It needs to be two winners. It gotta be somebody black. I'm sorry, Lindsay. Hold on, let me look to see if Michaels has any in stock. And we're about to have 2 to 3 winners. And to get this yarn, I did a vlog on it. I'm not sure the name of the vlog. I vlogged in June. I'll put the video up. I think it's gonna be up in this eye right here for the video that I filmed of me going to get this specific yarn. And I still had some left over from when, no, I didn't. I had to go get some more in September. Anyways, this yarn is hard to find, but I love it so much, so I do it. I'm gonna do what I need to do. I'm doing two. And it'll just be a little adventure between all of us. Okay, and I'm gonna remove her name so that it doesn't get her again. Y'all are watching this super live, and I can't wait for y'all to, like, see this after the giveaway, clearly, because I'm not uploading this video today, but to see how, like, figuring all this out. Okay. Who's the second winner? 21 people entered. Oh, shit! Oh my goodness! Aww. That's so cute! Okay, period. Okay, this is perfect. Okay, this is so good. This is also interesting too, because I've ordered from Douglas before, like 2021, and he made a shirt that I bought, and I think he dyed it himself. Yeah, on his fashion bag, in his fashion bag. But yeah, this is so interesting that he won too, because not only has he purchased from me, I purchased from him, and I also like to support him too, so. I can't wait to tell y'all that it was two winners and not just one. For the next giveaway that I do, I'm thinking that I'm gonna ask y'all what y'all want me to give away. I don't know, this rainbow hat, I just took a shot in the dark. It's one of my most like purchased hats this year, hands down. And now we really about to go on an adventure, because and I just got an email from Michaels today talking about I have rewards. Say less. I'm about to post it. Giveaway winner's announcement. A huge thank you to everyone who joined our rainbow crochet hat giveaway. Your enthusiasm warmed my heart, and I am beyond grateful for each and every one of you. The lucky winners are Lindsay and Douglas. Winners, keep an eye on your DMs for details on how to redeem your prizes. To everyone who participated, your support means the world to me. Stay tuned for more giveaway surprises and crocheted goodness. I have to go to Ghetto Hippie and I have to accept it as a collab post. Accept. I'll get back to y'all later. I need to run errands. I'm not sure if I'm gonna go out and get the crochet hat stuff today, but I'll get back to y'all when I'm doing something more interesting. So. Y'all, all I need are two bundles of this rainbow yarn. It said that there were two bundles of this rainbow yarn left in stock at this specific store. We're gonna see if that's what I can get. That's literally all I need. And there's like seven in stock at the one that's like 20 miles away at this point. I just went a whole nother direction, so. We're gonna see if it's in stock. I really hope it is. Oh my God. And I have to pee. So it's like, if it is in stock, do I leave it there, go pee, and come back and have it be gone? If I see it, I'm gonna hide it. If I see it, I'm hiding it. I don't see it. You guys, oh my God. Oh my God, I'm so happy. From where I went earlier to get this yarn, it said like 30 something miles. So I was taking a big risk by coming out here, but they had so much of it. And I'm so far away that it literally, like when I got out the car, it felt like I was in a whole nother like state. I was like, I've never seen these people before. Ever. And it just has like a different type of air out here, I feel like. Lean into me. Lean into me. Because of the time we shared, time we lost in love. If y'all are interested in this hat, it's on my website right now, and I'm actually making one for this order. It starts out like this, and then it'll look like this, and somebody actually bought the same one that I was wearing the same day that it was purchased. So tomorrow I'll be out in a completely different hat. I just finished the two rainbow hats. Look at how cute they are. They both came out differently, and this happens every time. I don't know how this one came out differently. I think it's just a yarn thing, but I love them both. Yeah, both of these are done. They're ready to ship out. It's 1:05 a.m. I finished the hat I was making. This is what it looks like. I haven't fastened off these yet, but it's done and it's so cute. Oh my gosh. La, 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 la. Today is Tuesday, January 2nd, 10:31 a.m. Today's quote is, "A happy life consists in tranquility of mind." Before I opened up this book, I sat here and I was like, let me just do nothing. So I sat here for like 30 seconds and just sat like this. When you think about it, it's kind of funny. But I just wanted to sit here and be still and be quiet. So I did that. So I thought it was interesting when I opened it up and said, "A happy life consists in tranquility of mind." Three things I'm grateful for: a dedicated pause, the one I took, waking up this morning. That's one thing that I always want to put down, and I'm always like, and when I think about what I'm grateful for, that one is always on top of the list. And I'd be thinking every time I am grateful, but that's just one of the things that I'm most grateful for, because I did not want to be here like almost a year ago. Like, I didn't want to be here, and I'm so glad that I'm still here. I'm so grateful that I am still here, and I get another opportunity to try again. That's really big, so I'm grateful for that, because not a lot of people have that. I'm grateful for another opportunity to try again. And then another thing I said I'm grateful for is Wednesday Eve. Maybe like a year or two ago, it seemed like a lot of things, like Wednesdays would be very impactful. Like, it's the middle of the week. My mom would always say that Wednesday was her favorite day of the week, because like it's close to Friday and the school weekend stuff, you know. When I think of Wednesday, I think of the color orange. That's my favorite color. And it just feels like exciting and happy to me. And I found that on Wednesdays, that's when I would do a lot of things. I would end up being booked in any capacity. If I worked at McCormick, I would maybe do something before work, go to work and maybe do something after work, or be productive like on my break at work. Like, that's how that kind of day would look. That's one like that I remember the most. But I just know like Wednesdays are a lot of activities happen, is what I used to think. I still think it happens. But the real kicker, the one that's been slept on, is Wednesday Eve. Tuesday is when everything happens. I don't know what I'm gonna tell y'all tomorrow, but I just know that Tuesday is the day to make it happen. That's just how I feel. I'm gonna finish my balaclavas today. I'm uploading to Instagram. That's it. The caption for the Shabert Day was, "Reintroducing my Go Shawty is Shabert Day crochet hat." For this rainbow crochet hat, I say, "A year ago today, I made this hat for the first time, and little did I know it'd be one of my best sellers of 2023, which is true. And I went back to my Huji app to see when I first took that photo of me finishing the hat, with the hat on my head. It was January 6th, and January 6th, 2020 is when I first launched Ghetto Hippie. Maybe I should include that too. And then I said, "I'm so grateful I get to share my art with y'all. This has
This hat has become one of my personal favorites to make. True. Six down, many more to go. I might have made 7, y'all, honestly, at this point. That's what I'm posting on Saturday. I need a video for Thursday.
Call you no bitch, but bitch, this motherfucker is clean. Call you no bitch, but bitch, this motherfucker is clean.
Call oh my you God. No making reels is so fun. Yeah, y'all, this is something about Tuesday. Maybe I can elaborate more. But the Tuesdays, everything happens. Super impactful. Okay. What would make today great? Discernment and wisdom from God. Discernment is really big. Is the discernment kicking in? I just don't want to be thinking with my own will. You know? And get caught up. Intuition is good, and going with that is good. I believe in that. But I don't just want to be, like, mindless. You know? I would like to be very intentional and listen and move forward with the best decision at the moment. Okay, next is uploading a reel and picture. That would make today really great because I crossed something off of my list, and I have officially started the what's it called my streak of 3 videos a week. Another thing that would make today great is being confident, being brave, and being heard. What would make today great? Another thing is a miracle. I love putting this down because I just love being like shocked in a positive way. Something that I did not expect to happen, but now it has me running through the house in excitement and joy. Those moments are hilarious to me. Oh my God. My daily affirmation is, I am bold. I am brave. I am courageous. I am a miracle in motion. My story matters. I am abundantly blessed. Thank you, God. Okay. I'm gonna read this on camera. I don't know exactly what it says yet. I only saw a preview of it because I was on the Instagram app and she sent it to me while I was in there. What's her name? I know her name. Why is her name blanking from me? China. So she sent me a DM an hour ago and said, oh, I put on my story. I put like a poll up on my story of which photo everybody liked better because, yeah, she replied to it. And then she said, oh, what she said 3 and 4, 3 and 4. Okay. She sent me a DM and said, 3 and 4 are neck and neck. Also, while I was cleaning my room, I noticed that I kept a card from Ghetto Hippie. You put some really kind words in there, and even now I appreciate it. You put so much positivity into the world with every art form that you choose, and I'm always rooting for you. Happy New Year. Say, bitch, don't make me cry in a nice way. That was so sweet.
Yo, what the fuck? Yo, what the fuck? Yo, oh my God.
Oh, this is what it's about. And when I saw the notification pop up on my screen, I couldn't read all the message, but I had seen enough where it said, I noticed that I kept a card from Ghetto Hippie. You put some really kind words in there, and even now I appreciate it. I was thinking, yo, I put that in there like 2020. It matters. It matters what you say to people. Yo, what? That's so good.
happened?
Y'all. Oh! That's what I'm talking about. Tuesday. Everything happens on Tuesday. All right, let me reply. That's another thing I want to get better at that I'm like, I feel like me reading this just now is what is helping me reply within a timely manner. For my DMs, for my text messages, if you're not like five people, no hard feelings, but I just don't reply that quickly. I don't. Unfortunately, even for like business accounts, I get a little like nervous. I don't know what it is. It's like I got a little stage fright sometimes. It's like, I know I put something cute up. I know I put something informative up. I know you want to interact with it. But it's like when I get that feedback, it's like, don't hide, bitch. You put that shit up. You put it up. Don't hide. I really just be in my own world, though. What she said was really, 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 really nice. And I'm so, yo, what she said? Oh, my God. I'm just thinking about my packaging back then, too. It wasn't the same as it is now, but I still like to put, like, affirmations in there. Anyways, I'm trying to reply to things and be more interactive and, you know, actually be a participant with the people that are showing love to me and that I love. I would like to show love back. Lead with love. Lead with love. Love is the answer, y'all. I am so okay. Clearly I'm beside myself. Hey, you guys. Today is February 3rd. I'm back home. Let me get some. My lips are feeling dry. Oh, Friday's event was very cute for Janae's business, Shay Love Shay. And I was able to. Y'all, every time I leave a pop-up, like, I am so inspired. That happened yesterday. I got home super late. My mom and I are watching my niece, but we're watching my niece over her house. After the event last night, which ended like around a little bit before 11, I think we were out of there. I went back home, packed me a little bag, and then I went to my sister's house. Girl, I got there around like 1 a.m. What time is it? Ooh, 8:27, perfect. I wanted to leave out around 8:30. So many things have happened. I'm not sure if I want to make this vlog a separate vlog. I think that it's all going to be one super large jumbo small business vlog. Yeah, I do want to include, because I posted it on my story today. That we had to put my dog down. One of my dogs, Bella, we had to put her down on Wednesday of this week. So it's officially been, today is the third day since she passed. And yeah, that's been really hard. I'm feeling like, and hold on, this is Griffey. This is my other dog. And I didn't mean to put him out there like that. But that's my other dog, Griffey. He's the boy dog. They were from the same litter. So I'm feeling like, you know, I took Griffey with me to my mom's house, to Livy's house yesterday. He's been by my side ever since. I've been taking him to the store with me. And today is going to be the first night that I leave him by himself. So not only am I taking him with me so that I can make sure that he's good and not feeling alone, but also like I'll be wanting to be with him because I feel alone and I don't, you know, he's my bestie too. So yeah, I did want to keep y'all updated. We're getting her cremated and her ashes should be ready sometime next week. So like the other day I grabbed Polaroids that I had of her, and I've just been like trying to collect all of the
things of her that I know that remind me of her. And yeah, to sort of just like keep her spirit alive. It was all really like sort of sudden. Like she's really old. I don't know if I'll get into the details of what happened, but like anytime soon, but we had to put her down. And I just wanted to let y'all know. And my body feels like low energy, but I know that I'll be okay. I just need to feel my feelings when I feel them. And oh yeah, keep it pushing. I'll talk to y'all soon. I gotta run a little errand before I go to my sister's house though. I've been making what I call a chiropractor sandwich. All you need is some bread. I guess you could go meatless. You don't gotta do meat. I do ham. I love Munster cheese. I love any like slice of cheese. Get you a slice of cheese. Choose your meat. Get you some chips. Which favorite type of chip? Do that. I really wouldn't recommend a tortilla chip on a sandwich like this. I'm about to tell y'all a tortilla chip that I use up. Hold on. I do blue Doritos recently. Blue Doritos on that sandwich. You're gonna put some ham down again. You're gonna put some cheese down again. Don't forget your sauces like your mayo, spicy brown mustard, things like that. You're gonna take the piece of bread and crunch down on that motherfucker. And you got yourself a chiropractor sandwich. In the past, some other chips that I really recommend for a chiropractor sandwich is barbecue chips. Oh my god, that salty sweet combo. Whew, so good. We're gonna go to the store first. Get me some blue Doritos. And also, I don't know why, but I'm kind of craving a slushie. Also, you guys, also, I think the groundhog's name is Punxsutawney Phil. Apparently, Punxsutawney and them is saying that spring is coming early because Punxsutawney didn't see its shadow. Or the reverse, however that works. And you know what I was thinking? Once my dog passed away, it made me think about like the day that it happened. I was thinking, oh my goodness, I wonder if like spring is gonna come early because my dog has passed and like she's ended a cycle and like is in the same breath like bringing new life and like renewal and stuff like that. How beautiful is that?